Aloha kākou, it's your friendly Hawaiian, Ke Kaimar. I work for the State Department of Land and Natural Resources, Division of State Parks. As a Park Interpretive Program Specialist, it's my key responsibility to connect people to our natural and cultural sites throughout the island, like Kaena Point State Park. To connect people to place, it's important I breathe life into Nawaiwai Hawaii, or the Hawaiian values. Laulima is an integral part of my work. As I interact with many local communities and diverse groups from around the world, I mālama aina, and it would not be possible without cooperation and many hands. It's my kuleana, my birthright, to have the privilege in protecting these resources, the ike, knowledge, and working the land to share the beauty and importance with people. Kaena means the heat. This remarkable state park and natural area reserve is found on the most western tip of the island of Oahu. It has significant cultural sites, one of the last sand dune ecosystems left in Hawaii, and rare wildlife that cannot be found anywhere else in the world. E hele mai, come along, but first we give ho'okupu, an offering of hula to Mākua Valley, as we are merely guests in this place. As we embark on our huaka'i, we must be thinking of safety first. Kaena lives up to its name, let's be prepared. Bring enough water and the right hiking gear for this 2.5 mile trek. Whether you're a local fisherman or a visitor to our island, Kaena offers its warm white sand and cascading coves through two remote trails. Keawaula and Mokulia are ahupua, or tracts of land from the mountain to the sea divided by chiefs for their people to sustainably use. As we traverse these rugged lands, remember to observe wildlife from afar. When in doubt, stick your thumb out. If it covers the animal, then you're far enough away. Remember to take the time and smell the, well, beach morning glories. Even the plants here are protected, as many are indigenous, which means they naturally arrive to the islands through one of the three W's, wind, wing, or waves. 4 million years ago, our islands were formed from a hot spot on the Pacific Plate in the middle of the ocean, 2,500 miles from the nearest landmass. Magma towered upon itself to the surface, forming a volcano and creating an island. The first of two volcanoes is the Waianae volcano mounting Kaena Point. The second is the Ko'olau's. During this time, many species evolved into endemic varieties. This means they are unique to the islands and cannot be found anywhere else. Several pelagic avian species call Kaena home and are loyal to their same nest each year. They depend on Kaena's sediment in order to successfully build their nest. The sand makes it easy enough to dig with webbed feet, yet there's enough soil to keep the den sturdy. This makes it that much more important to stay on designated trails. Kaena is a tough habitat to live in. Species adapted in many ways to withstand the intense sunlight, wind, and drought. How do you think this plant adapted? In a place so arid, how do Kaena's plants get their water? Some leaves are succulent, like this Iliahi aloe, and others have tiny hairs that collect dew. Like every one of us, each native plant has a story. It was Ma'o here who helped save the US cotton industry from pests in the States. He's our Hawaiian Superman. Good job, buddy. Many plants had a use to Hawaiians. Several had kauna, a deeper, hidden meaning, usually tied to myth or mo'olelo. Ohai is the kinolau, or bodily form, of the blind goddess Kaona of the Waianae Mountains. She would send her birds to guide lost hikers off the mountain. This limestone pohaku is the most significant site at Kaena. It is known as Lena Aka'uhane, leaping place of souls. Hawaiians believe that as you die, your spirit departs west. Your amakua, or family deity, would greet you at Lena Aka'uhane. If you were ready, your spirit would leap into po, the endless night. If not, your amakua would guide you back to your body. The Lena Aka'uhane is one of the main reasons Kaena is a wahipana, legendary place. However, over time and till this day, human development has impacted cultural practices and ecological well-being of Kaena. With the unknown of climate change, the growing population, and as a melting pot of the Pacific, Hawaii's native species and cultural landscapes may be in peril. Native wildlife are suffering from habitat loss and are being preyed on by invasive species, such as mongoose, cats, rats, and dogs. Please leave your pets at home. Endangered Hawaiian monk seals are being harassed by people and their dogs, and are being caught in fishing line or marine debris. Please clean up after yourself in the park. Today, the future is looking bright for Kaena, as many restoration projects are protecting its resources for future generations. This legendary place is full of wonder and life. Though it was a place for the living, it was also a pathway for those in between worlds. Many stories of important goddesses take place at Kaena. In some ways, Kaena is a fertile yet commanding ahuwa. Hawaiians observed these dualisms and hidden meetings, and knew they had to work together as it's an important wahipona to Mau Lama.